You know you bad, babe. You got me right where you want me. That's why they sad, babe. So many options, but they not popping. That's why you my lady, baby. That's why you locked in.
What's up, bestie? It's your girl, C the Mogul. You already know we're going global. And welcome back to my channel. If you haven't already, make sure that you subscribe and turn on the post notifications so you're notified every single time that I post. So by the title, you can see that we are going to be doing an updated lock moisture routine. I know it's been a minute since I've came and give you guys an update with the lock journey, how things are going. Those videos are coming up next, so just stay tuned for that, okay? Well, the next vlog, so stay tuned for that. But it has been 4 months with the locks, okay? It's been 4 months. They are growing, they are sprouting, they are doing whatever it's choosing to do. If you remember from my last video, I didn't have all the products that I needed. So what was the famous line? Use what you have until you get what you need. We got what we need. This video is going to be breaking that down, give you guys some tips that you guys can use for your own lock journey. If you're thinking about starting a lock journey, if you're indecisive, if you have already started, this video is for you. Stay tuned. So you're going to need the Holy Grail, some aloe vera. You guys can get, I got this from, I believe I told you guys, Publix in the last video. Get you some aloe vera. Get you some purified or distilled water. I got this from Publix. I think this is when I had that really crazy Publix run. And then I went to the hair store. I'm sure some of these products are in like the local department stores like Publix or Walmart, Target, Ulta. That's fine. Your girl's going to the hair store. At the rice water from Miel. And Miel, you're that girl. I just wanted to tell you that. If nobody else told you that, I just wanted to tell you, you're that girl. Got the Miel, sorry, the rosemary. It's the Miel Rosemary Mint Scalp and Hair Strengthening Oil. Strengthens. It does what it needs to do. And then I had to add this new baby on here because I seen it on another video. If I can find it, I'll drop it because y'all know I'm good for it. But if I can't, we'll pray about it. This, the black castor oil, the Jamaican black castor oil peppermint. Because they got different ones. Get the peppermint. Okay. Y'all know we done came up. We're leaving the bleach bottles alone. Upgraded y'all. Okay. Got me a cute little. Scratch that. Got me a new bottle as well. No, it's not like big, but that's fine. That's fine. Because you see, this is all I have left. So we're just going to make a fresh one. Okay. So stay tuned. So first thing that you want to do is just wash your bottle out. I mean, I just got mine from the hair store, so of course I'm just going to rinse it out a bit. The next thing that you want to get is your aloe vera and your purified or distilled water. I'm going to proportion it. It's going to be like a half to half mixture in a way for it because the bottle is small. So I'm going to just do 50-50 with it. But we're going to start with mixing the aloe vera and the water in first, and I'll be right back. To add the rice water in here first. I think in the last video I talked about how many drops you needed. If I didn't, just put like 3 or 4. Y'all already know from the cooking video we don't measure around here. We give it to the ancestors. You want to get your rosemary mint scalp and hair strengthening oil. This oil, to feel like scalp, like, you know, when you just get a fresh retwist or you just get your hair done, like that, your scalp is just really fresh. You place some of this in here, your hair is gonna feel like it's going through a minty breeze. Y'all, I am not playing. It's like some stuff is in here. 3 or 4 drops of the oil. Next is going to be the Jamaican black castor oil peppermint. Put like at least 2 or 3 drops. Now this doesn't have the Doppler like the other two do. So yeah. Now another oil I'm gonna put, it's not going in the actual bottle, but it is another oil that I like to use to seal
my hair when I'm done moisturizing it. But the Holy Grail, the mother of mothers, the girl of that girl, do grow. Mega thick. You know about do grow if your mama had to do your hair growing up. I use this to seal my scalp afterwards. She's really that girl. Everything is closed. Mix this up. Shake, shake, shake. This should last you a good like 2 weeks. I'm not even gonna hold you. My moisturizers can last me, honestly, up until I see my loctician again. Once you got a good mix, it should look something like this. And we'll be back. All right, guys. So now that we've got the moisture locked in, all I like to do now is just spray my hair. And I just be spraying, y'all. Spray until I feel like my locks got all the moisture that it needs to have. Because your locks can get really dry. What I've learned on this journey so far is just how dry your locks really can get. I'm so glad you called right on time. You must have just read my mind. If we skip the small talk, why you know? But I don't have to stay till morning. I don't have to pack no clothes. That's it. I'll get the do grow and I'll just put it through my scalp so it locks in what I just did. And then I'll get a scarf, get my bonnet, especially at night. That's what I do. All right, guys, so that is the end of this video. Like I said, just a little minor updates with my lock moisture routine. What I will say, just another key advice, do what works for your hair. Products is what I got from other lock queens and just other lock beauties that are, you know, starting off their journey. And it's working for me so far. Not even gonna hold you. So what I would just recommend always, just even in life, do what works for you. Do what is best for you and your hair. Because at the end of the day, it's not always about retaining the length. It's about making sure that we have healthy hair. And that starts with our roots to the tips. And if our roots are not in good condition, then how can we expect to retain any sort of length? Just be patient on this journey as well. I know most people are like, I don't know if I want to start it and the ugly stage. Baby, this is the ugly stage right here. And I'm loving it, okay? Thing, it's all about why you're starting the journey. It's all about what is making you continue on this journey. What progress do you want, you know, in your hair? What progress do you want internally? If this is more so on the spiritual side for you. A little update, had to drop a few gems for y'all because you know, this is what I do. This is what I do. I just wanted to encourage somebody because I know starting this life journey can be a little on the fence. It could be a little difficult. I know I have friends who want to start their locks and they're still like, you know, on the fence with starting it as well. So I want to encourage somebody, forget what other people are saying. Forget about how other people are going to view, how people are going to think. Your locks will get there. Okay. It's just a journey. You got to trust the process. And everything is going to come out fine. Okay. Thank you guys for watching. Make sure that you go follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and TikTok. All of my social media handles at See The Mogul. And make sure that you subscribe. Okay. If you got to the end of this video and you haven't subscribed yet, make sure that you subscribe to the channel and turn those post notifications on so you're notified every single time that I post. Okay. I hope you guys have an amazing day. It's See The Mogul. We're going global. And I'll see you on the next video. I need it. Your love is contagious.